In 1930, the Republican-controlled House of Representatives, in an effort to alleviate the effects of the, anyone? The Great Depression, passed the, anyone? A tariff bill, the Hawley-Smoot Tariff Act, which, anyone, raised or lowered? Raised tariffs in an effort to collect more revenue for the federal government. Did it work? Anyone know the effects? It did not work, and the United States sank deeper into the Great Depression.
For the first few years of my teaching career, I adhered to the existing culture, what the Brazilian philosopher Paulo Freire called the banking concept, and John Dewey labelled box knowledge, where children are treated as empty vessels in which knowledge can be deposited, great for passing tests, but not so good for getting them ready for real life.
I have a big interest in education, and I think we all do. We have a huge vested interest in it, partly because it's education that's meant to take us into this future that we can't grasp. If you think of it, children starting school this year will be retiring in 2065. Nobody has a clue, despite all the expertise that's been on parade for the past 4 days, what the world will look like in 5 years' time. And yet we're meant to be educating them for it. And my contention is all kids have tremendous talents, and we squander them pretty ruthlessly. What these things have in common is that kids will take a chance. You know, if they don't know, they'll have a go. Am I right? They're not frightened of being wrong. Now, I don't mean to say that being wrong is the same thing as being creative. What we do know is if you're not prepared to be wrong, you'll never come up with anything original. If you're not prepared to be wrong. And by the time they get to be adults, most kids have lost that capacity. If you look at the interactions of a human brain, as we heard yesterday from a number of presentations, intelligence is wonderfully interactive. The brain isn't divided into compartments. In fact, creativity, which I define as the process of having original ideas that have value, more often than not, comes about through the interaction of different disciplinary ways of seeing things. What TED celebrates is the gift of the human imagination. We have to be careful now that we use this gift wisely and that we avert some of the scenarios that we've talked about. And the only way we'll do it is by seeing our creative capacities for the richness they are and seeing our children for the hope that they are. And our task is to educate their whole being so they can face this future. By the way, we may not see this future, but they will. And our job is to help them make something of it.
The last thing I want to happen is for someone to come to me and say, actually, that's not how you do it.
Right.
Because great things happen when you have no idea what you're doing. You know, I honestly believe that if you're passionate and you're driven and focused, you can accomplish anything that you want to do. And it's to your standards, which should be okay.
Geography teaching generally involves children studying the Earth's landscapes and places, and also the relationship between people and these environments. It's traditionally a knowledge-based subject at primary school, yet there are so many opportunities to use it to develop other skills as well. It is important that children attain knowledge, in this case about rainforests, but how they attain it and what they do with this knowledge needs addressing. For Year 5 children at Hornsby House, geography was about to be used as a vehicle to develop their collaborative, problem-solving and research skills, and of course their talent for innovation and creativity. Each of the 56 children in the year group were given a plain cardboard shoebox, which would become the focus of their geography project for the next 10 weeks. Before they started designing the project, they were asked to individually research one of the following four layers of the rainforest: the emergent layer, the canopy, the understory, or the forest floor.
Collaboration depends on consideration, you know, like you have to extend your hand to the person that you're working with. If someone has an idea, you just have to try it. You can't really just shut something down and say, no, it's not going to work without hearing it.
Ideas and trying out lots of different ways to do things.
To me, creativity is your brain thinking differently than usual.
Creativity is freedom. You can do anything you want.
It's having ideas and being happy and proud of them.
It's a freedom to come up with any idea that you think is good.
It's when people come up with strange but wonderful ideas.
Once they'd designed the template and theme for their project, they were put into groups of four, each of them responsible for a single layer of the rainforest, but with the task of making sure that their layer fits into the group's whole project, when each of the shoeboxes was stacked, one on top of the other. This meant that they had to continue working together while they actually built their rainforests, so that they linked in with the layers above and below their own. Clichés become well-worn for a reason, and the children were encouraged to get away from the expected and really try and think about creating a project completely unique to their group. We knew we were heading in the right direction when they started asking questions like, can we make it out of this? And are we allowed to do that? Designing and asking questions on the edge of possibility resulted in some brilliantly creative designs using a huge array of materials.
A city on fire. Channels changing.